Well, this is a great evening, great time to speak with you. These videos are mostly being produced for viewing after the collapse happens. Financial collapse, the troubles that are to come, as something to latch on to and pay attention to. The fact is that the pace of life, the activity of existence, the pace of that must slow down drastically in order for us to regain our footing in the discipline that we need, which is to use the facets of each day as springboards to remind ourselves to focus in on what's most important, most profound, and to thin out our confusion. The pace of life today does not allow for that. Therefore, it is ruinous. In existence, something either expands or it contracts. It grows or it shrinks. And right now, spiritual focus, discipline in this world is shrinking almost to extinction. And that's not good, doesn't serve anyone well at all. For example, in the early morning when you wake up, you should spend several hours regaining your focus so that you can get into a profound clarity to start the day off. And then breakfast time, spend some time re-emphasizing that clarity and focus. Same with lunch, same with dinner. Evening time, you should spend quite a bit of time in the evening going over reinforcing. Every day should be like that. There should not be any days go by where the events of the day ever detract from this. Now, this routine is just for the ordinary householder, you know, who has a job, who works. The focus increases for those who are dedicated to a more rapid thinning out. They should spend more time, concentrated time, every day if they don't have to work so much. This is the basic routine. This is the way existence should be. And in order to accomplish this, of course, the pace of life has to be slowed way, way down. The trend has to be slowing it down. You don't have to be anywhere in a hurry. Nobody's in a hurry, okay? Does that sound like the world that you're used to right now? Nobody is frantic. Nobody's frenetic. Nobody's all jazzed up. Nobody's feeling like they've got to go fast, fast, fast. No pressure to get stuff done right now, right now, right now. Smooth, easy, calm, unhurried, with ample time to sit quietly and thin out the confusion. This is absolutely essential. And this is not being met in the world right now. Very, very tiny, small, negligible percentage may be meeting this almost extinct. And the trend is in the wrong direction. So keep in mind when you're examining your destiny that this is where you have to place yourself, because it takes a lot of patience to thin out the confusion that the mind has conjured up, because it's very tricky. It's so easy to forget. You go to sleep, you wake up in the morning, you've forgotten. That's why it sometimes takes hours and hours and hours to pull yourself back from that forgetfulness. And remember, oh yeah, now I see the subtle trick that's being played. I'm on to it. I catch the scent of it. It's like a hunting dog get up in the morning and being taken out and catching the scent and then tracking that scent. You have to really track it down with great discipline. Every day there has to be determination to track it down even better today. Can't let days go by without any effort. If you go to a restaurant, you still have to spend some time before the meal starts gathering your self, gathering your focus, and making a declaration of intention to not let the meal carry you away from your clarity. That's why prayer is used. Very important. It's just prayer is a declaration of intention to maintain focus. Before a meal, after a meal, before any event, after an event. That just should be just normal, obvious, intelligent functioning. If you don't do that, you are going to rapidly shrink down into imbecilic type of functioning and mindset. Like a sheep. Very, very easily manipulated and led into more and more and more subservience and feeling of being bound and enslaved. Which suits the purposes of those who are trying to substitute control for freedom. As if in controlling everything somehow that will feel just as good or better than perfect freedom. Which it doesn't. Doesn't really satisfy. So they want more control and more control. More subservience, more subservience. It's a lose-lose situation there. Not doing anyone any favors by turning into a sheeple. How to avoid that? Dedicated discipline every day, refining your clarity. There's no substitute for that. No guru can give it to you. A guru simply is a motivator. The best gurus are the ones who motivate the best. Towards daily, pragmatic, disciplined approach. Depending on your personality, your nature, it will be more or less structured. Some like more structure, some like less, some like no structure. Like myself, I don't like to structure anything. But I still do the work, get it done. Like it to be more spontaneous, but it still gets done. Every opportunity is taken. Like right now, beautiful evening. Opportunity is here. Seize the opportunity. It may just be a half an hour, a little opening here in this frenetic world that we live in. It's become so difficult. You have to almost be like a thief stealing the time to do it. And you feel almost like it's a criminal to do it, because you should be using this time to increase your pace of consumerism. Making more money, buying more things, going more places, reading more often, just cramming more and more into your day. Best time is to wake up early, stay in bed, and begin to clarify. Because all your thoughts, all this randomness, chaoticness, strange dreams, sorting through them, gradually letting the water settle until it becomes clear, very glassy. And then you remember, aha, you remember that counterintuitive, paradoxical doorway. You go through it, you say, ah, it's easy to go through it. And then you enter the profound, where your considerations are now profound. You know it. When you get there, you know it, because it's like you've gone through a paradox. And you see it's no longer a paradox for you. Easily resolvable. But it's so neglected that most people during the day, their activity, they don't have even the faintest notion that such an insight could be possible, could be there anywhere. Not even the tiniest, faintest notion. Forgetfulness is so profound. So it's tough as you go around and interact with the world in its state of profound forgetfulness. It's extremely difficult to get any cues, you know, from anyone to remember or go through the process of thinning it out, leading to beyond remembering, to knowing. You can play with that paradox there. Your mind, when you calm it down and focus it, you will be able to see, suddenly it will view some paradoxes, it will see some things, and will be able to go past it and say, aha, that's a trap, a trick that has keeping me bound and fixated and frightened. And now I can see right through it. It doesn't bother me a bit. But then later on, you know, forgetfulness will come. That's our habit. We're in this terrible, terrible habit of forgetfulness because literally the idea that we are presenting, that we chose to have presented to us by mind, is the idea of forgetting what we are. So, of course, we're forgetting. We're not really forgetting. The symbol that is symbolizing us, representing us, is scripted to be forgetting. But it really, it's not forgetting either, because it doesn't have anything to remember. It doesn't know what the self, what spirit is at all. So how can it forget? And spirit cannot forget what it is, but it can watch a movie where some actor is playing it upon spirit upon the screen, and this actor is pretending to forget. But this actor really doesn't know anything in the first place. So it's just all pretend. It's all pretense. Everything in existence is pretense. It's hypothetical. Hypothetical scenario of pretense. Pretending. But the way the world is right now, it is insufferably difficult . It's not so easy to simply retreat anymore . Not so easy for people to make money to survive . It's going extremely difficult the way things are set up with credit scores really determining your financial future. You cannot just simply default and say, forget it. I'm not going to work anymore. You will find the way things are going with credit cards, trying to get rid of cash, basing everything on your credit score. Those who want to drop out will find that they may be farther out than they want to be. Can't get back in. very drastic situation now. So of course people are very, very worried about their future, and rightly so. Because the way it's set up right now is really just crushing the opportunity, spiritual opportunity, which is the purpose of it. That's what mind is presenting, to keep us in a forgetful state, so to speak. Keep the dream one of severe forgetfulness. Spirit is watching this dream, observing it, and believing that the forgetfulness and the dream is somehow actual. It's pretending that it's actual. And so the dream needs to continue to be severely forgetful, not allowing the opportunity to thin the forgetfulness out to the point where it's realized that spirit cannot forget what it is. You can see through the whole scenario and realize it's just a scenario. It's just a pretend scenario that mind is producing like a movie. Opportunities to see that are becoming so rare. You know, you go now, all the time we have is to go, you might go to see a teacher, a guru, for an evening, a couple hours here. Maybe those with the money and the time might go to a retreat for a week or several days. But then that's it. And really, much of the spirituality of today's world is such that you do need money quite a bit to just attend events, to travel, to stay in hotels, to eat, just to stay up in a lifestyle where you have insurance, all the things that you need just to remain functional are so expensive that if you want to see these teachers, you can't just be a dropout with no money, because you'll be stranded. I know there's like a subculture of like vagabonds who help each other out, so to speak, but most people don't fit into that. That's a very, it requires a tremendously robust type of person situation to handle the rigors of a vagabond-like existence. Most are not cut out for that at all, cannot handle it. So opportunity is grinding to a halt right now. These YouTube videos are one way that I've seen that help can be given, because all you need is an internet connection. It's not, you know, prohibitively expensive. You can do it in with a friend, their place, if they have a connection. And the videos are free. Don't have to travel anywhere. And stay right where you are, minimizing your outlay of expenses as much as possible. Minimizing the amount of time you take in traveling and packing and logistics of all traveling. I mean, traveling is very difficult. Not many people are really good at it. It's an art. It's an ability. Many don't have that ability, cannot really travel. I don't have it. I cannot travel. Not able to, really. So these videos are like a, you know, like a little flickering flame that is still present in this world that enables people from all over the world easy access to be reminded what their responsibility is, what they must do in order to choose a new idea, meaning choose a new movie instead of the one that they're watching now, this pretension of forgetting who you are, what you are. And this is intentional. Spirit wants to forget what it is so it can be something greater. That's the secret. If you say, what is the secret? That is the secret. Spirit wants to be prime creator. How can it be prime creator if it knows exactly what it is? So what spirit is doing is it's claiming that it's forgotten what it is. It doesn't know what it is. Therefore making it seem plausible that it could be something, it could be prime creator. Right? The spirit says, I have no idea what I am. No idea. Therefore, I don't know what I am. Therefore, I can be anything I imagine myself to be. I can imagine myself to be prime creator. That's really the goal of all this, viewing this dream of forgetfulness. When spirit looks at this dream and says, ah, I don't know what I am. And that's what spirit wants. So that's what it's getting. It doesn't know, it claims it doesn't know what it is. It actually does. We do know what we are. But what we're claiming is, well, this movie, what we're seeing doesn't know what we are. So we're saying, well, something doesn't know what I am. That's not true. Because there is no entity in this dream. There is no beingness in this dream other than spirit. There is nothing else there's nothing that's forgetful in the dream. It's just all symbolic. So spirit can't claim, well, there's something really profound that has no idea what I am, therefore it's plausible that I'm not really what I am. Because this dream is saying to spirit, you're not what you think you are, spirit. You're something different. But by what authority does spirit claim that this is so? Is there something in the dream that's real? No, nothing. Doesn't matter if you claim the dream is made by God. Doesn't change anything. There's nothing in the dream that is real. It's all symbolic. It's all hypothetical. Therefore, how can spirit claim that it's actual, something actual, has no idea what spirit is all confused and thinks spirit's something different? Meaningless. Completely meaningless. But that's the claim. That's part of the claim. Spirit is trying to be prime creator for the fun of it. Why? Spirit said, what the heck? I want to try this. Should be interesting. Can I elevate myself into prime creator? Can I be my own creator? Create myself? But it's found out that this requires this incredible stupefaction of viewing this scenario we call existence, and believing that existence has some relevancy, something to convey to spirit that's relevant, that's meaningful. The fact is, it does not. It has nothing whatsoever to convey that is actual, was actually meaningful. Because spirit is spirit. Spirit knows what it is. Will always know what it is. Cannot forget what it is. Cannot change what it is. And there's nothing that can not know what spirit is, that can somehow, there's nothing that spirit can claim is forgetful of what spirit is. There isn't any such creation. All of creation knows what spirit is. All of creation is part of spirit. Spirit is part of it. There's no lack of knowledge or awareness anywhere in reality. Can never be. So these videos are here to help you. And after the collapse happens and trouble's there, you need to keep tune in and remind yourself all is not lost. Because everything that's being spoken here is just as true after the collapse as it is prior to the collapse. Exactly the same. These are truisms we're speaking. Absolute truisms. Never change. Doesn't matter how the dream changes, these truisms don't change at all. Dream can take on any type of format that it wants to. All these swirls and zigzags, like a washing machine turning around, everything's inside is just turmoil. Doesn't matter. Truisms are still 100% true and still easy to see if you turn your attention in that direction. The problem is that distractions, external distractions, are pulling at you from every direction. Now, if you're listening to this, you're not watching television, right? So there you go. You're probably not listening to the radio either. You're probably not reading a magazine or a newspaper or a book. You're probably not tweeting with your smartphone. You're probably just watching the video, focusing in, listening. That's called focus. That's called attention. That's called awareness. That's called discipline. That's called using your time wisely and responsibly. That's called being a real... that's called keeping it real. Meeting your responsibility is real, is keeping it real, so that it's dignified, full of grace and dignity and meaning and purpose. Because you're thinning out the confusion. You're weakening your fixation with this crazy dream that's supposedly telling you that you don't know who you are. This dream of forgetfulness where nobody knows what spirit is. Everybody's walking around seeking something, acting crazy. It's an insane asylum existence. Even the seekers are, you know, desperately seeking for something, and spirit saying, wow, I better see if they can find me, because if they don't find me, I must be lost. As if these automatons, these imaginary dreams, symbols, being scripted to go seeking, as if somehow, if they don't find spirit, then spirit must be lost. You know, that's the irrational, plausible logic, illogic, really, that this dream keeps on disseminating and spirit keeps on being afraid of it. For spirit to say, well, if these dreams can't find out, if these people in the dream can't find out what I am, can't find where I am, then I must not be what I am. I must not be where I am. I must be lost. I must be invisible. I must have disappeared. So spirit's watching all these people, all the scenario. Nobody is finding spirit. Nobody can find it. They're looking desperately, and spirit sees that and says, wow, I must be invisible. I must have disappeared. Nobody can find me. It's all a joke. It's all a scam. It's all nonsense. These dream-like symbols wouldn't know spirit if it bit them. They have no idea, no capacity to recognize spirit, to know spirit, to find spirit. They're blind. Blind and dumb by design. So it makes no difference whether if they cannot find spirit or see spirit or recognize spirit. It's impossible for them. They're just symbols. They're just concepts. They're just fragments of imagination. Like a suit of clothes being animated and moving around. A suit of clothes on a skeleton, on a meat suit. A meat suit on a skeleton wandering around aimlessly, and spirits all frightened saying, wow, they're not seeing me, they're not seeing me. This is very strange, you know. Maybe I'm invisible. Maybe I've disappeared. And then spirit's saying, aha, aha, good, good. That means if I'm not what I am and I've disappeared, maybe I'm something better. Maybe I'm prime creator. You see, so it's spirit's actually feeding on this delusion. This keeps the belief that it can be prime creator plausible to spirit. So these are the types of clarifications that one encounters when the focus is turned in the right direction, when time is given on a regular basis and discipline to use every moment, every opportunity, don't let one slip by, to reaffirm your purpose, your goal, your focus, your determination. These are the types of discussions and clarifications that are there for you. Anyone can see this, can find it. But you have to get in the habit of looking in the right place. And unfortunately, we are all severely habituated to looking in the wrong place, which is to look at existence, our perception, showing us this insane, meaningless wandering about of everything in existence, not knowing spirit, not finding spirit, being unaware of spirit, seeking in all the wrong places, coming up empty, struggling, giving ridiculous explanations for everything. A massive, massive swamp of all sorts of bizarre notions and concepts and ideas and beliefs swirling about, ever-changing, phantasmagoria, kaleidoscopic presentation of meaninglessness that stuns us, keeps stunning us all the time. We're stunned by the complete stupidity, the imbecility of existence. It's imbecilic by design. That's the whole purpose of it. So if you're thinking that we're all going to wake up, forget about it. That's not the purpose of existence. The purpose is to make to keep everything completely imbecilic, to give the pretense of nobody knows where spirit is, nobody can find it, nobody is even getting close. It's just, we've even given up. Says forget it, can never find spirit. And spirit will say, I can't be found, I must be gone, I'm no longer what I used to be, I must be something different, therefore I can say, maybe I'm prime creator. That's how it's working. Existence will continually present this complete futility, severe futility. And of course, in the window dressing will show we're all ascending, consciousness is going to awaken, we're all going to remember spirit. That's the marketing of it. But that's just superficial. Beneath that is this massive, aimless futility taking place constantly. You see, if it didn't have at least some hope, spirit might just say, wow, you know, this is just too much. I don't really want to forget myself entirely. You know, spirit really doesn't really want to forget itself. No. It's playing at this. It's pretending at this. And if it gets too severe, spirit will say, forget it. I'm tired of this idea. I'll choose a different idea. So in order to keep it all plausible, has to seem like existence is really getting somewhere. It's on the trail of spirit. It's almost tracked it down. It's almost found it. Spirit likes this. It's almost found me. Okay. And then what happens? Failure. Didn't quite get it. Spirit will say, okay. Well, it's plausible then that maybe I don't exist. Maybe I have no beingness. I've disappeared. I never was what I thought I was. I'm something different. This is the play that's going on continuously. There's always being trumpeted that everything is going to be great. We're going to find spirit. We're going to find spirit. No, nothing ever does in existence. Those who awaken are simply spirit choosing a different idea and realizing, this is all just a delusion. I can't be found because I'm not lost. What is there to find me? There's nothing other than myself to find me. I already am within myself. How can there be anything outside of myself to find me? That's ridiculous. Completely insane. So it's not that they found spirit. That's not the realization at all. It's that they realize that there is no finding necessary. It doesn't matter whether someone claims to find spirit or not find spirit. That's both are completely ridiculous. So this type of talk and discussion and clarification, thinning out, should be a daily enterprise in your life. The business of your life should be these clarifications. And the place where you live in should support this. The culture should support it. The village, the town, the city, the state, the country, the world should support this. This should be the A number one. Responsibility. Culture should be supported entirely. Slow-paced, kind, gentle, allowing the time and the space to do this. One should be able to go somewhere and just sit anywhere, in the town, on a bench, in a park, on the beach, the mountains, wherever, in a restaurant, wherever, and just sit quietly, like in meditation and contemplation. And nobody should bother you. In fact, everyone should be very supportive of that. There have been cultures like that. India used to be that way. Everyone was very supportive of this. Anyone could stop anywhere they want, simply sit down and meditate, and nobody would say a word. In fact, everyone would say, "Oh, thank you for taking care of your responsibility and reminding me what my responsibility is too." And every time someone does this, it's a reminder to everyone else. But we have become so uptight. That's a word from the 60s. Because it was in the 60s that this incredible uptightness, this incredible pace began to take off like a missile. We entered the jet age, the missile age, the atomic age, the high-tech age, where incredible acceleration took place and everyone was so uptight. Like, how dare you sit there doing nothing? It's a crime. And of course, we fought against that. We struggled against it, but we lost. Got crushed. Absolutely crushed. I say there's very few who still have the spirit to do this. It's a losing cause, a losing battle in this world. You cannot. People will think you're insane if you just sit somewhere, or you're walking along on the sidewalk and you just stop and say, "I think I'm just going to stop here and look into space and spend about 20 minutes clarifying something. I just had a very, very good insight. I need to clarify it." You know, they'll call the police. They'll run a psychiatric evaluation on you and then give you, tell you need to take some drugs, because we can't have people, you can't have people stopping anywhere. It's like the whole purpose is to increase the speed and efficiency of everything. We're like blood cells in a massive corporate body. Every blood cell has to have some purpose and be speeding somewhere as fast as possible to carry that purpose and carry that material there and drop it off, and that someone needs to else pick that up. You know, everything is like on a tight schedule, very tight schedule. It's gotten tighter and tighter and tighter and tighter. Everyone is so uptight, it's unbelievable. It's amazing you're even here watching this video. Probably have to sneak it. So in your prayers and focus on your destiny, focus on this. Say, "I want to be somewhere where I'm allowed. This is allowed. I'm allowed to be disciplined, spiritually disciplined. I'm allowed to just stop at any moment. Just stop. Stop and drop and focus. Maybe when I'm eating, in the middle of eating, suddenly I can just stop eating and say, I need to focus here for 30 minutes, however long it is, because I see an opportunity to thin it all out. I suddenly saw through the paradox, the insanity of what's going on. I need to get familiar with that. It's a process of familiarity. How can you carry out a process of familiarity if you have no opportunity to do it? Because it's repetition. It's doing it in all different circumstances until it becomes second nature or first nature to you. It's very familiar. You can do it easily. So pray for that destiny for yourself. It's not a rigid thing. Like I said, you can be It can be spontaneous. You can just be taking a walk somewhere and you just say, hey, you know what? I'm just going to lean against this tree and not go anywhere because I'm going to spend, you know, an hour or whatever time, however long it takes, just to really focus in because I feel like I want to do that right now. Other people can be passing you by on the trail and they just smile and say, it's beautiful, man, that's great. And maybe they'll stop somewhere along the trail too and do that too because they see you doing it and say, hey, okay, I remember I need to focus in today too. And there's a, maybe they'll find their opportunity. Maybe they'll sit down by a river and watch the sunset. And as they're doing that, they'll be very quiet and calm. And they'll sort through the thoughts and everything will calm down. And then they'll begin to see through the paradoxical and the stupid and the imbecilic and the foolishness and the fixation and all the fears. And they'll thin it out. Then they'll get up and move on their way. Maybe go back home. Nobody will think badly about them. They won't be screamed at. Like, where have you been? Hey, were you working? You know, what are you doing? You're lazy. You know, all this stuff. It's crazy stuff. So there should be a destiny that supports genuine spiritual effort, the right kind of effort, the right kind of responsibility. That is what we are pointing towards. That is what I am focused on, is finding that type of supportive atmosphere and situation. Otherwise, no matter how good the teaching is, how clear it is, it'll be ineffectual, both of those. Because nobody has the time for repetition and to practice daily, many, 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 many times daily to break the old habit of forgetfulness, of fixation on this foolish quest to be prime creator. The teaching will go in one ear and out the other. They'll get a little feeling like, ah, okay, that was profound. That was great. Okay. And then, gone. Gone. Complete forgetfulness then will intervene once again. It's habitual. Breaking the habit is very difficult. But it can be done. Has been done. Has been done in this world. In cultures that were supportive of this. Some Buddhist cultures were very supportive of this throughout history. Some Hindu cultures, some Christian cultures, some Islamic cultures, very supportive of it. Different times, different places, very supportive of this. Some, you know, other types of cultures also were supportive. Just walking slowly. You know how many people walk really slowly anymore? Driving slowly, going slowly. Not in any hurry to get anywhere. Because you know what's more, it's not getting somewhere that's important. It's taking the opportunity, seizing the opportunity that presents itself to go within, to focus on the profound. That's what's important. So, every day should have the space to take breaks whenever you want to. Doesn't need to be a whole lot taken care of or done. And I'll talk more about this in another video of potential worlds, potential places where things are different than they are here right now. Because there is a potential, actually. I will get into that in another video. You wonder, how can it be possible? You know, our life right now is so intense. And how, you know, we have to work to eat. You know, there are worlds where things are different. So, look forward to producing that video sometime soon. All right. Very good. Very good time. Well spent. Excellent. All right, that's it.